Hey, Shalom. I'm going to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rekah Kodash, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, Shalom to the elect. I'm going to title this lesson, As It Was Written, As It Is Written. You know, because the understanding of the New Testament, or the New Testament, is basically the understanding of the Old Testament. And, you know, what caught my attention is, as brothers, you know, we always go into this verse right here, Romans 8, going into Apostle Paul and him catching hell. All right. So this is Romans 8 and 31. What shall we say then? What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay up anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Yahweh Shai that died, yea, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Yahweh Shai? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? Which is a question mark, meaning, shall any of these things separate us from the love of Yahweh Shai? From what he did for us, from him dying on the cross for us? Hell no, man. As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. You know, and many times in the New Testament, you'll see as it was written. Because the understanding of that time, of that particular time, like when Paul was going through this, he was thinking this, man. That's why he said, as it was written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long, we are counted as sheep for the slaughter. And that's in reference to Psalms 44, I think it's 22. But I'm going to start up at 19. Psalms 44 and 19, though thou hast sore broken us in the place of dragons and covered us with the shadow of death, if we have forgotten the name of our power, or stretched out our hands to a strange God, shall not God search this out? For he knoweth the secrets of the heart. Says, yea, for thy sakes, we are killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. So Paul had the understanding of Psalms the 44th chapter, man. Going into how our people sinned against the Heavenly Father. They went after other gods. Alright. When you read this chapter, they went after other gods. They completely disregarded the words of the Heavenly Father. And for that reason, the Most High, alright, He put hell on them. And he's still doing it to this day, man. You know, and us in the knowledge, you know, it's, we thought like this, man. We still think like this, man. Like, why are we to pray? Why are we why are we on the bottom, man? Why are we catching the most hell, man? All right, because we have sinned against the Heavenly Father, like the Apostle Gabar said. A good mindset. Let me see. I think it's in Micah 7, or Malachi. 17, maybe. Oh, I forgot how it go, freak. It's locky. Let me see. I think it was 5, actually. 5:19. Oop. Got one more. I know the Apostle Gabar had brought it out. Let me see. I have sinned. Let Okay, Micah 7 and 9. I will bear the indignation of the Lord because I have sinned against him. Until he plead my cause and execute judgment for me, he will bring me forth to the light and I shall behold his righteousness. Because all Israel sin and they getting judged from the Heavenly Father. But us, more so, all right, being in his truth, man. All right, and you know, having an understanding, you know, having our eyes open, having an understanding of who we are, what we have done to the Heavenly Father, it hurts, man. It hurts to, you know what I'm saying, go through this. But with the understanding, Psalms 40, you know, with the understanding that Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah has blessed us with, all right, therefore, we take it cheerfully, you know. The scriptures say he that have understanding is not soon mad or something to that extent, you know. So we always got to go back to the scriptures, all right, to conquer those fiery thoughts from Satan, you know. Because like I said, all the men of old thought like that, man. All right, but to get us through, as it got Apostle Paul through, we go back to the scriptures, man. That's what it means when you read Isaiah 33 and 6. Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times and strength of salvation. You know? Not only we always go into a Jacob's trouble. Alright? But even now, man. You know, we have to implement these words now to keep us stable. You know? It's Proverbs chapter 7. Let me see. I wrote this down. No. No, it's locked in. Let's see. Four and 17. Slovakia. Four, Slovakia. Four verse one. It says, hear ye children, the instruction of a father, and attend to no understanding. And when you, before you read, you should ask the Heavenly Father, you should ask the Heavenly Father that to allow me to receive righteous instruction. Natan la ya tazadak yasar. For I give you good doctrine, forsake ye not my law. For I was my father's son, tender and only beloved in the sight of my mother. He taught me also and said unto me, let thine heart retain my words, keep my commandments, and live. You know? And through these words, we are retaining, you know what I'm saying, our flesh, man. Spiritually speaking, man. We understand who we are now. We understand what's to come. We understand that our power is the most high in his son, Yahweh Shai. Alright? We understand that we're not Africans or Spanish. You know what I'm saying? We understand our power. You know, it says, he told me also and said unto me, let thine heart retain my words, keep my commandments and live. You know? And this is how we're going to live, man. The spiritual fight, first and foremost, and then on to the physical fight in Jacob's trouble. By retaining the words, man. Let's look up that word retain, Proverbs 4:4. Let's see. Okay. Proverbs. Keep fast, follow, take up, hold up, maintain, all right, stay up, let thine heart maintain, or keep fast my words, man. You know, it says, get wisdom, get understanding, Slocky, I keep doing this, get wisdom, get understanding, forget it not, neither decline from the words of my mouth. And every day, you know, as we meditate upon his word, his truth, we understand the grave, the severity of us going against the Heavenly Father. You know, like I said, we're under the lowest of the low, man. You know, having to take orders from the lowest of the low. Esau, the so-called white man. All right, the caveman. That's why his name, he's called himself what? A Caucasian. All right, he's red. He's not actually white. That's why we call him so-called white man. But this is back at Proverbs 4 and 6. Forsake her not, and she shall preserve thee. Love her, and she shall keep thee. You know? And by keeping these words, we're going to have a stable mind, man. Through the hell we catch. All right? It's the fiery trials. All right? Like I quoted Isaiah 33 and 6 that these words, all right, shall be the stability of thy time and the strength of salvation. That's how we're going to make it on these ships, man, by keeping these words. You know? Or by utilizing the words. You know? For example, you know, let's say the last days, man. Or even now, man. You feel like you're going through something right now where it's no way out, man. Or it's too hard for you, man. All right? Then you start thinking about scriptures like the Most High didn't give you nothing. Now, you can't, Romans 10, I believe it's 10 and 13, the Most High didn't give you nothing. Now, you can't, didn't give you nothing too hard for thee. You know? Oh, when you catching hell after hell after hell, man. The scriptures say, what? When thou comest serve the Lord, prepare thy soul for temptation. All right? Or one of my favorite ones, 1 Corinthians 11 and 32. How we are chastened now so that we won't be chastised with the world. All right? Or what? 1 Peter 1 and 6, man. You know, how the trial of our faith is much more precious than gold that perisheth, man. That we may be found with praise and honor at the appearing of Yahweh Shai. Alright? So the trial of our faith is very, very, very precious, man. You know, it says exalt her. I skipped verse 7. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. You know? Like I said, man, when you go, when you read the scriptures, man, many prophets of old, the fact that they understood, you know, what Yahweh, you know, put in a book in the Old Testament, what Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai wrote into us in the Old Testament, you know, they weren't shooken at the times, man. You know, this is John chapter 12. In verse 14, Yahweh Shai, when he had found a young ass set thereon, as it is written, fear not, daughter of Zion, behold, thy king cometh, sitting on an ass colt. No, actually, Slocky, I'm going to start up. Yeah, I'm good. John 12:15, fear not, daughter of Zion, behold, thy king cometh sitting on an ass colt. These things understood not his disciples at first, but when Yahweh Shai was glorified, then remembered they that these things were written of him, and that they had done these things unto him. All right. So they remember, all right, of the prophecies that was written beforehand, man. The words that Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai put in the Old Testament. All right. Hey, the scriptures also say, brother, we always get into wisdom. Things that are written aforetime was written for our learning. Let me see. For whatsoever, Romans 15 and 4, for whatsoever things were written aforetime, were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. You know? So we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope, man. Hey, I was watching a brother, GMS's time. He did a video about, you know, having faith, or not having faith, rather, can be to your demise. Something to that extent. And as I was listening to him, I was thinking about the things that the Most High did, like, he made Sarah. He allowed Sarah to have a baby, man, at an old age, man. Elizabeth, all right, Hannah, who was at one point barren. So there's nothing impossible with the Most High, man. You know, but that's why scriptures say, "What? Study to show thyself approved, man." All right, and it also tells us to eat the whole roll. So all these things, that the Most High told us wasn't for nothing, man. All right, and the more you read, and you know what I'm saying, the more you go through experiences, you'll see that, man. Even myself, man, I'm learning daily, man. You know, this is John. Last precept. Probably ended out with this. John 14. And 23. Okay. I like that. John 14 and 23. How shall I answer and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. You know? And that's what the elect, that's who the elect are, man. The elect, these words are written in their heart. He that loveth me not keepeth not my sayings. And the word which ye hear is not mine, but the Father's which sent me. These things have I spoken unto you, being yet present with you. And that's how we know, man. All right, us is the hopeful elect. We supposed to keep these words, man. All right, and that's how you prove that you love the Lord. All right, not, you know what I'm saying, just lip service, but your actions, man. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name. You know, hey, you know, I just thought about it too. That's how you prove you love the Lord, man, even through the slandering, man. All right. Like the apostles before him, man, they counted it all joy, man, when they caught hell for Yahweh Shai's sake. Because he told the apostles, man. He told his disciples, you know, you're going to be persecuted for my name's sake. It says, these things have I spoken unto you, being yet present with you. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things. And bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you. You know, it says, peace I leave with you, this word. My peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled. Neither let it be afraid. You know, so hey, let's bind these. You gotta bind these words upon thy heart, man, that it will give you long life, man. You know, cause our goal is to make it up in them chariots, man. You know, our goal is to make it up in the chariots, and the only people that's gonna make it in the chariots is the elect, man. Who, you know, what I'm saying, who died for the Lord before, man, who caught hell for the Lord before. You know, like I was watching one brother, GMS, I Hate My Life. He brought out a beautiful point of how, you know, the elect, they've been through this before, man. They caught hell for the Lord before, you know. And how they do it? By keeping the words, man. By keeping the words that, Yahweh Shah just said it, man. It says back in John 14, 26, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you. Hey, you know, so keep the words, man. You know, get into this word, man. Pray to the Lord, man, that he put the words and he seal righteous instruction in your heart. Hey, so with that, Lord William Ockham was edified. Shalom to the elect.